Hey guys, it's Shelby. Welcome back to my car. So today we are going to be talking about the one and the only Bridgit Mendler. Bridgit Mendler is an interesting case because I feel like she is highly underrated, but every once in a while a tweet or a TikTok or something will go viral saying that she's underrated. And if that many people agree with it, is she really underrated? Now, if you've never seen one of these tweets or TikToks before, then you may have no idea what I'm talking about. You may know her from Good Luck Charlie, but did you know that she makes really good music? Her 2012 album, Hello, My Name is Bridgit Mendler, is incredible. She is a really good singer. Her voice honestly fits in really well with current popular indie music. Since this album, she has also dropped, I think, at least one EP, maybe two EPs, and some singles here and there. I'll share a couple of those songs as well, but this CD is going to be the main focus of today's video. Basically, I'm about to give you 13 plus reasons that you should stan Bridgit Mendler right now. Starting with song number one, baby, we're getting right into it. This song is called Ready or Not, and I'm under the impression that this is probably her most popular song, either this one or Hurricane, and I don't know why I think that. I think maybe Disney Channel used to play these songs on TV. I'm the kind of girl who doesn't say a word, who sits at the curb and waits for the world, but I'm about to break out, I'm about to break out, and hit the gas quick, ready or not, here I come, where you at, the night is young, in the crowd, the music's loud, but I will find you, ready or not. I mean, come on, her voice, this song is so catchy. Good vibes all around. Also, I didn't mention this, but I love the cover of this album. She looks so good. Like, look, she has all those like highlights in her hair that are different colors. Moving on to the next song, this one is called Forgot to Laugh, and I might be putting you on this one if all you know is Ready or Not and Hurricane. The chorus of this song is so powerful. The power that Bridgit Mendler holds, truly. Ready? Ignoring the fact that I feel incredibly awkward, wasn't that song so good? The next song is called Top of the World. How does this one go? You got that. Okay, this song has a really good verse. You got that fresh way of talking. It could be 4 in the morning. And you're making me trip my heart. Skip, skip the beat. The chorus is about to come up, guys. You're not even ready. Take the road. Some of the lyrics, I will admit, are a little bit cheesy, but I guess you could also think of them as being kind of poetic, depending on how you look at it. So, moving on to the next song, this one is Hurricane. So, I'm assuming a lot of you guys know this song. I think Disney Channel definitely played this song. She almost, like, raps in the song, doesn't she? Kind of? Like... Think the clouds are clogging up my brain, like the weather drains, same as the tears on my face. And I'm stuck up in the storm, of this song is so good too. She's like, I am floating. All right, next we have City Lights. I remember this one being one of my favorites, I think. It's like a castaway, feeling so cross, like a renegade, and I'm trying to call out in the big city, just a small voice, and no one's listening to me. Tell me where to go, tell me that you know, uplifting song, right? That's not, like, a lot of these have been about love, but that one's about, like, self-love. I keep looking over this way because this poor guy is trying to wash graffiti off of the wall, and every time he stops, he looks over here to see if I'm still dancing. Okay, we're gonna skip a couple songs. So the next song on this album is called All I See Is Gold, and it's a pretty good song, but it's a slow song, so I can't really jam to it in the car. Then we have The Fall Song, and the chorus of The Fall Song is really good. The chorus is really good, but the rest of the song I don't really like a whole lot. It's a bit cheesy for me. Then we have Love Will Tell Us Where to Go, and I can't really remember how this one goes that well, but I feel like it gives you like running away with your lover vibes, like traveling. I don't know. I can't remember. Let's listen to it. Ah, so good. Are you kidding me?
I know exactly how you feel. It doesn't matter what you say. I see the sun begin to set, and we gotta get away. If I could push them off the ticket, stack them on the wall, I'd rip them down and leave the town before the cops could call. Take on the road, let's go crazy. Love will tell us where to go. I'll be your girl, be my baby. Love will tell us where to go.
Song is just composed so well. Like, I love how at the beginning, like, you're like gradually adding more instruments. Like, it just starts with the snapping every once in a while, and then it gets more and more, and then the whistling kind of like carries you through the song. I mean, I could see this being like on an alternative indie radio station. I'm very impressed by that song, thinking more about it. Okay, the next song is called Blonde. This is more of a fun song for her. Like, some of these other songs I feel like are very mature. No hate on the song, because I like this song, but I'm just saying it's a bit more fun. It's fun. It's about being a blonde.
I thought you were a really nice guy. I thought you were just my type, but I forgot your name.
Perpetuating stereotypes about blondes. No, but really, the lyrics are kind of silly, you know. It's just her embracing her stereotypical blondness. I don't know. It's nothing that I think would ever, like, probably make it outside of, like, Disney Channel. But next, we have Rocks at My Window, and I think I'm gonna skip this one just because it's just a fun pop song. Pretty catchy. And the bridge, I'm pretty sure she starts chanting, T-H-R-O-W-I-N-G, you're throwing rocks. I wish you were throwing rocks. She's chanting throwing rocks. Okay, we're just gonna move past that one. The last one on this album I'm gonna show you is 515, because this was one of my favorite songs on the album, even when I was only 13 years old, and I feel like this is kind of a more mature song. It's a slower song too, but I get it stuck in my head a lot even nowadays, especially when it is 5:15 or I'm like up early in the morning. It gives me very much early morning at the airport, going somewhere mysterious vibes.
Out of Tylenol, it's still 8. Got enough strength to flip a pancake. Got the luggage bag waiting by the front. 4:45, it's already 1. I'll say it one last time. Walking out the door for
5:15. The way that song switches from like minor chords to major chords, incredible. That song always transports me. In fact, I'm pretty sure it used to be my alarm clock. So I would just wake up pretending like I was in a movie. Now there is one more song on this album. It's called Hold On For Dear Love, but it's not really my favorite or anything. It's just a slow piano song, kind of showing off her vocals. So I don't feel the need to show it. What I am gonna show you though is maybe like one or two of the newer songs that she's put out. Yeah, so she put out an EP in 2016, which actually is not as recent as I thought it was. Why is there a dude on a motorcycle? Yeah, so she put out an EP in 2016 called Nemesis, and it only has four songs on it, but I really like the song called Library.
Saw you from over a shoulder in the corner with a bunch of peeps that go to the high school. I remember when we were in the yellow building, never friends, same hair, and the same old crew. Light blue, neon glowing, tippy toeing, try to spy without you knowing.
Gonna show you maybe like parts of how does this one go?
Deep underwater is where I left my love.
I don't like the song a whole lot. The beginning's cool though. Here, how about this one? So I feel like her 2012 album is a little bit more indie pop, whereas this is more just like modern day, like synthy, like electronic, you know, modern sounding pop. This motorcycle, I swear. I don't know. And I think she has released like three singles since then. Like she put out one in 2017 and she's been putting out remixes of it. But yeah, my car is 100 degrees. And I say that very literally because it is 100 degrees outside right now. So moral of this story is stan Bridgit Mendler. She is very talented. And Bridgit, if you're watching this, you know, where's the new music? Like we want more music from you. Yeah, so thank you guys so much for watching, and if you aren't subscribed to my channel already, subscribe. I post a new video every Saturday. Also, give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. With that being said, I hope you're all doing well, hanging in there, staying safe, and I will see you all soon with another video. Peace out.
Stop.